Hello, everybody, and welcome back to Insider's Guide. Today, we're discussing the highest and busiest ski resort in all of Europe, Val Thorens. While it is crowded, there are plenty of spots to find some room, which I'm going to talk all about in this episode of Insider's Guide. If you haven't already, go check out Part A of the Travalis Insider's Guides, the top link in the description, as it has crucial information that'll help you understand what I say in this video. So with that, let's begin an Insider's Guide to Ski Resorts. Edition, Val Thorens. We begin with the Col de la Chambre. The Col de la Chambre is how 95% of everybody coming from other ski areas gets into Val Thorens. Because it is blue and the easiest trail to access from Col de la Chambre, Pluviomet is one of the busiest runs in the whole of Val Thorens. This side of the valley also never gets a break from the sun, unlike the other side, which is cast in a shadow for most of the afternoon. As such, Pluviomet's snow conditions deteriorate quickly throughout the day. The other problem with Pluviomet is that it doesn't get you into Val Thorens' center. The first lift you can access at the bottom of Traverse Montelier is Plein Sud. That means you'll have to ride up an extra lift to access these four lifts in Val Thorens' center. Chardons is a short little red, but is on the steeper side as far as reds go. Mériel Gottsched the Black is extremely busy and can develop mogels as soon as late morning. However, Gottsched can still be a nice lap around noon, when there aren't a million people all trying to get into Val Thorens at once. Chardons and Gottsched are led by the Travalis high-speed quad in Fenetil. These two lifts get pretty long lines. Don't worry about picking the shorter line, however. The lines for both naturally even out to be just about the same time. These upper trails also flow into Plein Sud, which is a wide blue trail frequented by lower-level skiers. To access Corniche from Chardons or Gottsched, ski to the skiers left of the top of Pionnet Lift. Otherwise, you won't be able to get to it. Corniche is just a road anyway, so I don't find it too annoying that it's hard to access. Plein Sud gets busy from having two six-packs feeding it, and can get skied off relatively quickly. Most days, I still find it tolerable, though. In Val Thorens' center, there are four main lifts and a number of magic carpets. There are the Lac Blanc, Pionnet, and Cascade six-packs, and the Fenetil, Piquelet. Piquelet is one of the busiest lifts in all of the three valleys. If you're planning to take Piquelet to lap these reds here, I would highly advise taking Lac Blanc instead, whose lines are always shorter time-wise than Piquelet's. Piquelet appears to have a massive capacity, but in actuality, has about the same capacity as a fully loaded fixed-grip triple chairlift. Off of the Lac Blanc chairlift, I recommend the Croissant Red. Béranger gets much busier, as it's served by both Le Blanc and Piquelet, and also Cascade to some extent. Off the top of Piquelet, a majority of people go left to Lac Blanc, which is on the easier side of reds, or right to Béranger, but both of these reds flow into this runout, which is technically still Béranger. This part is crowded and icy, so I try to avoid it, although it can be a nice long red lap from time to time. Via Lozé and Ardois are all pretty much roads to allow access to and from other reds and lifts. Adrien Thio and Yannick Richet are not often open to the public, but they're nice and empty if they are open. Off the right of the top of Piquelet is Tête Ronde, a long rolling blue. If you're looking to lap blues, Tête Ronde isn't a bad trail, but I typically don't lap it because of the lines at Piquelet. Christine serves one purpose, and that is to allow you to access Portet and Morin from Piquelet. More on those two in a minute. Pionnet tends to be the least busy of the four Val Thorens centre lifts. It's certainly consistently less busy than Plein Sud, the other lift going to the same summit. On some less busy days, Pionnet won't be running. If you get to Pionnet and it's not running, just ski on down to Plein Sud. Cascade is a shorter six-pack that practically parallels Piquelet. It is frequented more by beginners than any of the other three lifts in Val Thorens' center. Cascade is one of my least favorite blacks because it's so busy. Everybody sees it riding up the chairlift and decides they want to do it, which results in beginners on a black and poor snow quality. I much prefer the blacks that are harder to get to, which deter those that really shouldn't be on a black trail. Dalle is a nice, shorter blue, while Bleu is more of a road. Doucombe and Flocon are also roads, which some people don't mind. Stockholms is another trail that allows access to mid-mountainless. Combe de Torrens is a main funnel in Val Thorens. Everything above flows into Combe de Torrens, along with all the beginners lapping cascades. It's super wide, but it still feels jam-packed during the holiday weeks. Add into that mess the fact that Combe de Torrens is completely flat and even a little bit uphill for half of its length, and you understand why I avoid the trail like it's the plague. We'll discuss an alternate trail soon. Just below Val Thorens center are two trailers on the side of the trail. Oddly enough, both start on the opposite side of the face they go up. When coming down the Cairn Trail, the Plaine Sud six-pack goes up to the right, but it starts on the left. The Du Lac high-speed quad, which goes up the left side, starts on the right. Plaine Sud's lines tend to move pretty quickly. Du Lac's don't. Most people don't realize that you can take another chairlift called Motir to access everything you access from Du Lac, so Du Lac tends to get unnecessary long lines. If Du Lac's line is back up to the RFID gates or further, just keep skiing. Now, Du Lac is slated to be replaced with a gondola soon, so this may not be a problem anymore in the near future. But for now, there's an alternate chairlift to take to avoid the Du Lac line. Chalet is a very popular bully trail that I try to avoid. There are much better blues to lap elsewhere that don't have half of all the six-year-olds on planet Earth on it. This Traverse du Lac is not very much a traverse. It's much more of a traditional green trail. It can be busy, but I don't find it absolutely miserable like I do Combe de Torrens. It's a useful trail to access the two mid-mountain lifts after you come down Pluvumet. If you keep skiing down the blue trail again, you'll come into another hub area. This area is called Val Thorens Basse. We'll come back to it in a while, but for now we're just going to focus on one lift, the Motir six-pack. Motir isn't terribly busy, and it's certainly never as busy as Du Lac is. Like I was saying earlier, if you want to take Traverse Du Lac, but the Du Lac lift is busy, just keep skiing and take Motir lift instead. Le Nord, which runs in this direction from Motir to Du Lac, isn't all that bad, and then you're right there on the run you want to be on. Something that's absolutely baffling me is that the trail Hermine doesn't have snowmaking. Because it's accessible from both Motir and Du Lac, it gets skied off very quickly, so I advise hitting it as early as possible if you want to ski it. Arose is another of those super accessible blacks that I hate. Now, let's get back to the area I consider to be mid-mountain. There are two lifts here, the Moraine Gondola and the Portet six-pack. Moraine is much busier than Portet, but neither really get lines, except for on the busiest days. Wedged between the two is the Chalet de Torrens. Chalet de Torrens is my favorite spot for lunch in all of the three valleys. It's quick if you need it to be, and it offers a ton of options from tacos and burgers to crepes and waffles, and even to regional specialties like tartiflette. Back to skiing, Off and Moraine are two really nice blues. This is absolutely an area I would recommend lapping. They're nice and mild, plenty long, and have decent snow coverage. This cold lift doesn't exist. It was taken down a few years ago to preserve the glacier and due to the lack of use. I'm not sure why it's still on the Val Thorens trail map. You can see it doesn't show up here on the Three Valleys trail map. Off of Portet, you can go down the Portet Red, which is flat at the bottom, or you can go down the Fond Bleu, which is flat at the top. Pick your poison. Nord Fond is a runout for all of these runs, and the Grand Fond Pod, so I try to always take Rodos instead, as it is much less crowded than Lower Fond. Portet can get pretty icy, but the other two runs maintain good snow. The way that the Finito runs is that it's reversible, like a tram, which means that up to 80 people unload at the exact same time, and start down the run all together. As such, Chocard is busy in pulses. I try to beat the crowd down. It's a really nice trail if you avoid the big group, but it can get hairy if you go down with everyone else. Chocard is one of the more difficult blues that I've found. It's rather steep for a blue in my opinion. To get back to the Finito, you need to keep a lot of speed at the bottom of the trail. This trail, Asters, is one of the most forgotten runs in Val Thorens. It's not great for lapping, but I do try to take a run on it once I'm done lapping Chocard. Now, let's move to Grand Fond, one of the best and worst areas in Val Thorens. Grand Fond is serviced by a Finito that, similar to Peclet, has a much lower capacity than it appears to have. It can be busy, as it serves a large part of terrain and also provides primary access to Orel. To access the Veneto, you need to take the blue trail, Lagoped, from Motiecielift, or the Plateau Bleu from Portet area. Plateau serves as an alternate to Combe de Torrens, as you can then ski the remainder of Lagoped to the Jonton trail, and then you'll be in Val Torrens Basse. The Plateau Paumé are helpful connector lifts for the opposite direction and also serve this terrain park, which has boxes and rails. Further down, after you fight your way through the crowd into a Veneto, you'll find your legs getting zero rest as you stand with 30 of your best friends for a few minutes until you get to the top. Wait a minute. This is an insider's guide, not hater's guide. Whoops. As soon as you get out of the cabin in the top station, you'll be faced with a large open door. This door serves all of these runs off of Nivelles. If you're looking to go to Boulevard Vezelle, keep walking along the platform until you see a smaller door, unless you want to hike all the way around the building. Nivelles is entirely a road from Grand Fond all the way to Chocard. This little stretch that splits off in parallel to Chocard is more of your traditional blue. Médaille is a nice shorter red. I've skied it several times without encountering another person. Variant is the second most popular run in the pod, so I prefer Médaille and Falaise over Variant. Etalou and Lower Chemin are quite nice, but Upper Chemin is a road that switches back several times. It's a bit difficult if you find yourself in the middle of a crowd. It's got incredible views the whole way down. In fact, the whole of Grand Fond Pod has great long views down the Belleville Valley towards Le Menu. Boulevard Vezelle is actually uphill, so enjoy that. As I mentioned, Falaise is a much emptier red than Variant. It's much shorter than it appears on the trail map. If you ski past the bottom of Grand Fond, continuing down Lagoped, you'll find yourself at the bottom of Chimcheron Tram. The tram is massive, with the capacity of each car in the triple digits, so don't worry too much if there appears to be a line. If it's under 100 people, the longest you would have to wait is about 5 minutes. The vertical climb of the tram is so large that oftentimes, the top will be entirely in the clouds. If you're not comfortable with skiing in the weather presented at the top, just take the tram back down. On sunny days, the summit offers its famous panoramic views of the Alps. The Red Run Chim is extremely long and has many flat spots. It is helpful to get back to main Val Thorens, although I'm not sure why you'd be going all the way up to Chimcheron if your intent is making it to Val Thorens center. Col de la Zune is a much nicer red that doesn't require pushing. Combe de Caron and Cristal are two very difficult blacks, but because they're not as readily accessible as Cascade and Avrose, they're much more fun with better snow and only other good skiers. Down in Val Thorens Basse are four lifts. We already talked about Montier. There are two gondolas, Cairn and Caron. Cairn I find to be quite useless with one exception. The Cairn Trail is extremely busy, on par with Combe de Thorens. As such, it is certainly not a run to be lapped. In fact, to get to the Caron Trail from the top of the Caron Gondola, you have to cross a road before you put on your skis. However, from the top of the Caron Gondola, you can ski a little cat track through the heart of the village to access Becle, and even Cascade, if you really feel like traversing in front of 1,000 beginners who can't exactly stop on a dime. The Caron Gondola is much more useful. It serves two purposes. One, to access the Chimcheron Tram, and two, to lap the Jontien Trail. Jontien is not as wide as one might think, but it's still not bad. It's very mild, and I'm still not quite sure why it's a blue, but it can be a nice lap. Cairn and Caron don't tend to get lines. The other lift in Val Thorens Basse is Boismint. I haven't seen Boismint with a true line. Boismint is not exactly my favorite chairlift for reasons to be discussed in Hater's Guide, but in actuality, it's just fine. Armoise is a short little black that I've found seems to have consistently bad snow quality. It's ungroomed, so the areas in between each mogul tends to have grass and shrubs poking out through. Hautecombe is a nice long red, although I have found that sometimes, for a reason unbeknownst to me, they groom the upper part, but not the lower. Although Hautecombe and Jontien appear very close to each other on the trail map, they aren't actually all that close, and they do not connect at all. Planchu is one of my favorite blues, as it is consistently empty, at least in comparison to Val Thorens' other blues. The bottom of Planchu takes you back to Boismint, and if you want to get to the gondolas or Motier, you need to take Ores, which is a traversal road cut for exactly that purpose. Boulevard de Téléphérique is just a road that connects Boismint area to Chimcheron. Tétraz is a nice empty blue, although unlike Planchu, it does not have snowmaking. Couple that with the fact that it's at one of the lowest elevation areas of Val Thorens, and it can be quite icy or slushy in the early and late season. The Plan de Loup six-pack also never has lines. The Bois-Mit and Plan de Loup trails also follow with the theme of empty but poor snow in early and late season. Bois-Mit to Plan de Loup is the upper part of Boulevard Schumann. While Schumann isn't famous for being incredibly flat, this upper part isn't terribly bad if you go fast. It has snowmaking, so its snow is typically good. Lower Boulevard Schumann, which is managed by Le Menuy, doesn't have snowmaking, so it's much worse. This Red Run Chasse is accessed from both Pluvemet and the Brieuse Gondola in Le Menuy. It's often forgotten about and is much less busy than the three runs at the Col de Deschamps. It's just a road, but I much prefer it over battling crowds up top. You then take Plan de l'Eau, from which you can take the boulevard over to the tram or ski down into Val Thorens Bas. Now let's head over to Orel. The Chimcheron is where the tram goes on the front side. As such, from the Chimcheron tram, you can ski down Combe de Roselle into Orel. And from Orel Chiron Condola, you can ski down Chim or Col de la Zune into Val Thorens. Combe de Roselle is an extremely difficult trail. I won't spoil Hater's Guide, but I have plenty of gripes with Combe de Roselle. The trail is a little bit hard to find. When you first start your descent from the top of Chimcheron, you go down a very short initial slope before the run curves to the left. To get to the black, you need to stick as far left as you can go around that curve. There will be a little bit of access road that splits off to the left while the rest of Col de la Zune curves back around to the right. The Col de Roselle is where the top of Grand Fond is. This trail map doesn't really do it justice, but Morenis is a wide red run that pretty much goes straight down the face of the mountain, while Gentillon is a switchback road that keeps crossing Morenis. As such, I prefer Morenis. The views never stop going down either trail. This blue trail, Le Riz, comes from the top of Thorens Funetel. It's a road along the top, widens out and has a long slope here, and then has a long run out here. Go fast down this trail, as the run out can get very long and flat. Le Croix d'Antide is really shallow, as instead of going down the Perron face, it goes around it entirely. Perron is a little steeper and shorter than the Croix d'Antide. Pouchet and Croix are two reds that don't really get busy. Now for the lifts in Orel. There are two gondolas and two six-packs. Orel Caron and Roselle will get you to Val Thorens. Neither tend to be too busy, while Roselle typically being empty even when Orel Caron starts forming lines. Perron can get backed up from time to time, but because the other two don't, I typically just take more laps on Roselle while I wait for Perron to quiet down. Overall, Orel always has shorter lines than Val Thorens because it's farther away from the village and is harder to get to. The Orel gondola is an extremely long gondola that connects to the actual town of Orel. It's one of the nicest gondolas you'll ever ride. This Chalet Chenin Donet, because it is only a restaurant in all of Orel, gets pretty busy. I would highly recommend going to Val Thorens for lunch. Well, that's about it for Val Thorens, and with that concludes the Trois Vallées Insider's Guides. As always, please leave any questions down below. If you haven't already, go check out parts B, C, and D about the three other main areas in Les Trois Vallées. Thank you all so much for watching. All my love, I'm out.